$14? You can't be serious. Crystal Dynamics, I know this game feels like it should be free, but you already charge people full price for it. You don't get to charge $14 for lazy-ass tank top and jeans skins. Even if you were a free game, like Fortnite for instance, at least the emotes that you buy in that game can be used on any character. Emotes in your game are locked to the one specific hero, and you can only use one at a time, as of the recording of this video. What are skin rarities even for, if not exactly for this reason? Even in the context of your video game, this skin isn't worth $14, a legendary skin? It's a shining example of this game's laziness on full display 4 months after launch. It's wrong. Start correcting your error. Have you ever been to school? You can't just tell people what they want, you need to supply their demand. You've been attempting this tell people what they want approach since launch, and look how it's worked out for you. I admit, normally they would probably be right to think that fans would just gobble up anything that you put in front of them. Let's be real, if you know any fanboys, you know that they're the biggest suckers.
But of course I know it.
But when you personally light the fire that vaporizes all of the goodwill that you could have had up until this point, you get this failure. We don't have to tell you anymore that we would have bought MCU skins. We don't have to tell you that we would have bought comic book skins. Because you see the millions flying into the wallets of Insomniac and Epic, who deserve every single cent. Because they were wise enough to secure these characters' likenesses, and they unapologetically made these heroes cool, heroic, sexy, to match their historical representations in movies, in comic books, in TV shows, in just about every fucking source of media, so that when we Google the name of this hero, the people we see on that front page, they are similar to the representations in the game. They weren't so woke that they refused to show any flesh, but only on the women, because men showing flesh is totally fine. They didn't sabotage their own game with character models so ugly that I'm forced to swear that someone on the design team must hate these characters. You should be ashamed, because this is a disgrace. I've no reason to exercise restraint when you're asking free-to-play economy prices for garbage in your full-price game at a price point of $14 for a tank top and some jeans. You're so excited about these voice actors, but you have heroes that effortlessly embody the worst-looking incarnations of any Avenger in any video game that's licensed officially by Marvel. Heroes in the Marvel Universe are sexy. Not just the men, women too. Equally sexy across all genders. If you're too stupid to put these girls in their iconic, form-fitting catsuits and leotards and confidently have them show a little bit of flesh, at least as much as their male counterparts, then you might as well just make baggy, loose, riot gear skins for Black Panther and Spider-Man like you've already fucking done, because you're so stupid. Crystal Dynamics, I want you to stop. I want you to stop squeezing the soul, the beauty, the creativity out of the successful, long-lasting properties that have existed well before you and will exist after you. It isn't broke. It doesn't need fixing. You are the problem. Crystal Dynamics, you're the Zack Snyder of the superhero games. If not for your explosively competent and talented combat team, this game would definitely be a memory in every gamer's fucking mind. Stop. Be normal. If you hate your job, quit. Stop ruining what people like, because there's no mistake here, you're ruining this. If it were something you cared about, chained by the ankles, being dragged through the fucking streets, you'd speak just as passionately as I am right now. If it's too much effort, move off this Marvel property. Leave it to someone else. I haven't wanted to put this idea out there, but earlier this year, Ghost of Tsushima came out of nowhere and released a co-op mode with multiple legends or heroes that players can play together. If Insomniac Games decided to release a co-op mode with multiple heroes, even if they were just Spider-Man, we already know they take care of their fans, so we would probably expect to see Spider-Verse skins, more Spider-Verse skins, because they already fucking got them. A co-op mode in Insomniac Spider-Man game would effortlessly be what people wanted, and it would effortlessly already represent its source material, even though it is an adaptation better than pretty much anything you're mixing up over here. The more you think about it, the more you wonder if this game even deserves a swing at Spider-Man, at ruining Spider-Man. When Black Widow swings in this game, her forward momentum is compromised. She's literally slower than if you were to just jump and run forward. It's so bad that to even connect with the next object to swing to, in some instances, would mean that you have to lay off forward so that you can catch it, because otherwise you'd overshoot it. Does this sound like intuitive design? Does this make sense? This is the Marvel's Avengers you get after years of development. It wouldn't be so bad if there were 6 villains to fight, at least one for each hero. Wouldn't be so bad if there was a patrol mode. You know, the thing Destiny had 6 years ago? Destiny launched with 4 factions, each with individual subtypes, variety in its locations. Part of me wants to believe that the MCU skins are actually on their way and they're just waiting for a next-gen release, but this game owes its early adopters 4 months, 2 villains, 1 enemy type, 0 Marvel locations, bad loot and a looter, bugged dailies and a live service. The worst skins that you're probably ever gonna see. Skins that could all be made free, that many would still go untouched. This is a beta. And I beg you, viewer, go listen to my early videos. I had hopes, beliefs, that this game could potentially be good. That was the biggest phrase with this game, potential. I wanted the X-Men in here. I wanted Doctor Strange and Scarlet Witch in here, but now I think about it and it's like, at what cost? With how viciously this game beats characters with the ugly stick, the price of their inclusion may be too steep. You don't get to pretend that you exist in a vacuum. Crystal Dynamics, if your game was the equivalent of launching an internet service provider, you would be worse than dial-up, but charging the same price as the high speeds that people are used to. If you were a gamer, and I were the dev, I'd respect you if you stood up and recognized garbage for what it is. Your game is and will continue to be a failure. Your shop will continue to turn people away until no one cares to even look if you can't put respect on the name. Put some respect on these characters. People don't know you. They don't want to know you. Give them what they want and everything will be fine. I give credit where credit is due. Thor's furry shoulder skin, bro. Unworthy Thor. Gladiator Hulk. These are what legendary skins in your game should be. But you cannot get away with not paying proper homage to the beautiful, powerful, and confident women that fans have loved and never rejected in their flawless and perfect forms. Who would argue that Scarlet Witch and people like Jean Grey aren't easily some of the most powerful heroes in the Marvel Universe? They showed it without having to destroy the men around them. Do you get what I'm saying? But if you slide in some new character and literally, I'm not joking, pretty much immediately just go, oh well, this is girl Goku and she's stronger than Goku, like she can teleport and use portals, and she has high-tech gear, but also she uses a sword, and she's an archer, and she has quantum energy, and she can fly, you know, bruh. This isn't even an exaggeration. That's the worst part. This is Marvel history, all of 80 years of it. These girls, they haven't even been around for a quarter of that history. Crystal Dynamics, I know you're the type of company to DMCA strike people over mods in a video game because they're portraying women in a way that, I just can't, you know, if it was a nude man mod, you'd be all right though, right? It'd be totally fine. So let me say this. For all the clickbaiting and rambling that Super Rebel does, You know what I respect him for? The recognition that you will get more people clicking if you use the real iterations of the Avengers, not the ugly garbage in the thumbnails that you have in this game. Wake up, Crystal Dynamics. You can create your safe spaces for virtual backpats over female Mr. Fantastic and discount X-Men with this forgettable-ass Inhuman campaign that you call a story, but you'll never be able to silence the deafening mediocrity of the product that you have made available for purchase. Try as you might, you won't be able to hawk it off on these good people because they've been made aware of what you're doing. Now only hard work will turn the tables. I had more passion and hope in my pinky finger for the future of this game being a potential spiritual successor to Marvel Ultimate Alliance than double the losers climbing up out of the sewers to comment how I must be a hater because I'm not exclusively praising the game. But you know what? It feels good to have a working brain. And I'm gonna go ahead and take you back to the internet's first reaction to Marvel's Avengers all the way back in June. My lord. User footballman 15 says, it looks okay. Notice those dots though. But the Captain America suit is fucking atrocious. I seriously hope they offer different suits. Yep, that's the first thing you want after a reveal is everybody begging, please God, can I make them look not like this? User Peth Sir says, it kinda looks like a mobile game trailer for a cheesy turn-based strategy game. User LMAES246 says, they didn't have to use the MCU likenesses, but damn, did they use some knockoff action figure stunt double versions that look 10 years older, made with Madden football face scan. Bruh. If I were to rate this poetry on a scale from 1 to accurate, I'd scale it Crystal Dynamics' Avengers the video game. But you may be saying weirdos on the internet are one thing. It's not like anybody's writing a real article about it. What's going on Forbes? Oh my gosh. Paul Tassi contributes, why does Crystal Dynamics Avengers game look so weird? Be cool of Marvel to give the stunt doubles their own game. Hashtag Avengers. I fixed the new Avengers trailer, boys. The internet is not being kind to Square Enix's new Avengers game. I love it whenever we have anything real or critical to say, suddenly we're not being nice, you know what I mean? What they really want is for us to shut the hell up. Shut your mouth. Just shut your mouth. But you know what? Some of us know that sometimes the squeaky wheel gets the grease. And look at this. A response reads, during the GameSpot interview, it was said that the team behind the game have been reading all the criticism and feedback from the fans since last night. And apparently, not a damn thing came of it. It's crazy to take a look back, isn't it? If you made it this far, thank you for embarking on this journey with me. Follow me on Twitter or Twitch, same username, join the Discord, all the links are in the description. You'll see me in the future covering this because... I can't say I'm not loving it. This is just it's sinking, boy. It's like it's a ship that sinks, and then it pops back up, and then it starts sinking again. it's like the train come off the tracks, and then it go back on the tracks, and they come off again. Oh my God, it's happening again.